be taking one little shimmer.
Be okay.
Trying to make us feel good?
A little shimmer. Be over. You won't have to worry about your burial insurance and nothing.
You trying to make us feel good?
Realistic.
Thank you.
And my kids won't be worried about that. We always tell them.
So we can have a little fun in here. If I could actually have everyone more along this wall, it'll make things a lot easier. It does not have to be a single file, as long as everyone can see. You can take it like that. Shorter people in the front. So this is a replica of a lantern we found. And yes, this is all it was. A can with some holes, a handle, and what's left of a candle. Keep in mind, everyone on Darrell's tour would have one of these. If you are scared of the dark, now is a good time to close your eyes or hold somebody's hand so you have the illusion of control. So, everyone secure?
Yeah.
Notice how only the child answered.
I know.
From the mouths of babies.
So, up to the first 2 years of tours, nothing but this.
Oh my God.
Again, everyone would have one. And once your eyes adjust, you'll see there's a little more light than you might expect from, well, this. Enough light to still kind of see where you're going. You know, I'm so glad I'm not in a pitch black cave with nothing but a single candle to light my way. You can still see the fairies dancing on the ceiling, like I mentioned earlier. Good thing it wasn't the 70s, otherwise this might be the disco caves. Two major problems, though. One, you cannot see the details. And two, this is a living, breathing cave system. If I could have all the phones and cameras dimmed for one moment, so there is no alternate light source, please and thank you. And then go ahead, blow it out. Oh, we still have the phone glowing? If we can. Okay, maybe not. Alright, wave your hand for your face. Touch your nose. Mine's glowing. Watches it off. Can you see your hand?
Except for over
here,
we're
not so long. No. So north is that way, south is that way. You guys are great, and I'll see you all. I'm kidding. I wouldn't do that to you. Well, we learned something cool about our caves. Our caves react to black light. The purple is the calcite, the lime green to white impurities in the calcite. When it glows like this, it's called fluorescence, kind of like the lighter colors people like to wear. All the whites are very popular. You would just be a target in laser tag. Very nice. Oh, I see that. You went to the big hot springs. Okay, so it's actually kind of funny. I've never actually been to the main hot springs here in Glenwood. And the first time I learned that they stamped your hand with a stamp you can only see in a black light is because it was this little girl. I shined the black light at her face. Was just glowing from the stamp. And also rubbing her face to the back of her hand. And I'm like, what the heck? And that's how I learned about the big pool hot springs. Alright, now, for the cave. The steel back the show.
Whoa.
When it continues to glow, it's called phosphorescence. There is a science to it, though, with molecules of the rock reacting to the EV spectrum. These are the fairy caves, so another possible explanation is pixie dust.
This like glowing dark thing.
Natural glow
it up. Well, thank you.
She
is. She's a good guy.
Not a boring.
Are you okay, dear?
No.
That'll be fine.
Will you be okay before you get married?
Maybe.
Okay. That's a saying in my house. Oh, you'll be okay before you get married. All right. So, next we're going to go around the corner to the right. There's a little bit of a slope, so please watch your step. It can be a little slippery. So, come to me, my darlings. Otherwise, my last person becomes my first person and we turn up. Ugly last.
Yeah.
Yes, just watch your step right in here.
Let's not go tumbling down little dark holes, shall we? So, it started off with a lot of planning, so we knew where every light bulb was going to go. And then a group of cavers took in a couple electricians, fully garbed, so we can do the least amount of damage as humanly possible. Then we hit it all, so you can see the cave, not what we did to the cave. All right, so here's what's going to happen next. We're going to continue on, end up going down a little hill. It gets a bit steep. Please watch your step. There is a rail. Should you need it, we like to call it a stalagpipe. Thank you for acknowledging my jar cave. At the end of that passage, you get to see some more formations, but it's a really small spot. Then you're going to go up the stairs to the next room. Halfway up, even more formations, including flowstone, that looks like Willy Wonka's chocolate river, and strips known as cave bacon. Can't forget cave bacon. But to start it all off, do watch out for Headache Rock. It's got its name for a reason. Beautiful.
We're very proud of our cave system. So a stalactite holds tight to the ceiling. A stalagmite you might trip over. And a column is very neat. And yes, that is what we really do, column. Bless you.
Column the column?
Yes. Thank you. And if you end up on my next King's Road tour, you will hear that one again. So that is indeed water. It's reflecting the ceiling, even though it's only a few inches deep. So once you see this, you're more than welcome to head up the stairs to the next room. Don't forget, halfway up on the right-hand side, Willy Wonka's Chocolate River strips known as Cave Bacon. But do watch your head. Let's watch it. Really low is that.
Cave Bacon.
So it's the
left
side.
Okay.
Where it gets thin and streaks around, like right there.
Yeah.
It's bacon, like right there. It's... I should have worn my boots. I wasn't thinking about the cave.
She didn't tell us where to stop.
Well, this is it because there's no lights. So.
Dark creepy alley.
Until she turns the light on.